Hi, my name is Kuljit Bhamra, and in this presentation I'll be talking about Indian drumming, and in particular the Indian tabla drum. I'm also very, very excited and thrilled to announce the launch of a product that my team and I have been working on for the past 5 years at Keda Music, which is the name of our company, and it is this, which is the world's first electronic tabla drum. The first thing I'd like to say about the electronic tabla is that there is no intention whatsoever that this replaces the acoustic tabla. I think that would be a foolish thing to assume, and it's certainly not my intention. However, I have a strong feeling that this may be a more accessible gateway to find out more about tabla playing and Indian drumming.
Lead engineer Laurel Pardew here. Now, in an effort to address some of the challenges related to learning the tabla, particularly the maintenance in the classroom, difficulty tuning, the physical bulk of the tabla, and also the ease with which tabla may lose its tuning, we have built the electronic tabla. There are existing electronic drum and hand drum options, such as the Roland Hand Sonic and the Korg Wave Drum. However, none of them are appropriate for capturing the feel and the technique of the tabla. Tabla technique features a relatively unique and complex playing style that involves damping the head and striking in specific locations to select from a range of tones. The electronic tabla detects the position and pressure of both strikes and damp concurrently, including the strike force. Our sensing approach allows us to successfully capture primary tabla technique as demonstrated by Kuljit, starting with the reproduction of the tabla's characteristic glissando. As you can hear in that clip, another characteristic sound of the tabla are the rapid-fire strikes. The current audio output is sample-based, which allows easy and stable retuning, as Kuljit will also demonstrate.
And I can also tune the left-hand drum if I wanted to. They can be tuned independently.
The strike classification for sample selection also makes it easy to generate MIDI or OSC for controlling other instruments or producing notation, which is of particular importance in the case of Keda's wider goal to make tabla more accessible and easier to notate, and to spread that notation. The sample bank approach also means it's easy to expand the inbuilt sound libraries and also reconfigure the strike surface to match other hand percussive instruments. Right now, we already support a wide range of sounds from other traditional Indian drums like the dholak and non-Indian percussion, as Kuljit will demonstrate.
If I go to a hang drum, and you'll notice now that the zones have been reconfigured for this particular instrument.
Thanks for watching our presentation, and for more information on Indian drumming and how to teach yourself tabla, please check out our website, keda.co.uk.